Hi everyone, today we'll be discussing about molecular docking. Before we go in detail about molecular docking, we'll be seeing what is the definition of a molecular docking. So molecular docking is a method which predicts the preferred orientation of one molecule to the second when bound to each other to form a stable complex. You know that in molecular docking, basically we dock ligands to proteins. So protein is a biological macromolecule and ligand is a small organic molecule. So when ligand combines with the protein, it forms a complex, that is ligand protein complex. So before this ligand binds with the protein, they should be oriented properly. Just for example, as you can see, if this is the structure of the protein and this is the site, this is the active site shape, this is the shape of the active site. Now if you compare, this is the ligand, this is one orientation and this is the another orientation of the ligand. So there are two possible orientations of this ligand as of now for explanation. So which ligand orientation is most suitable for binding with the protein? So this ligand orientation will be more suitable for binding with the protein and not this one. As you can see, there is no shape complementarity between this form, but there is shape complementarity between this ligand structure or conformation and this protein conformation. So here you may understand, the docking is a method which predicts the preferred orientation of one molecule to a second when bound to each other to form a stable complex. It is a method of predicting binding conformation of small molecule ligands to the receptor binding site. So this is the receptor binding site and this is the conformation of the ligand which is most suitable to bind with the protein. So docking will allow us to predict the orientation of this ligand conformation and protein conformation. So this is the definition of molecular docking. So in reality, this is the protein, the complete structure is not shown, but the active site structure is depicted, in which there is some shape complementarity between, this is a ligand which has gray sticks and blue color markings and red markings, and the green color one is the active site description. So here you can see that there is some shape complementarity between the ligand as well as the active site of the protein. And before we proceed with molecular docking, we'll just find with some important definitions of which are involved in the process of docking. Receptor, as we have said, a receptor is a protein molecule or a polymeric structure which binds a molecule called ligand, which binds a molecule called ligand, and when this ligand binds to the protein, the cellular response is observed. Either it may be inhibited or enhanced. So what is a receptor? Receptor is nothing but a protein or any polymeric structure like a nucleic acid, or it may be a protein, or it may be an enzyme, and it binds to a small molecule called ligand. And after the ligand binding to the receptor, the function will be exhibited as a biological response or cellular response. What is a ligand? Ligand is a complementary partner molecule that binds to the receptor. So receptor binds to the ligand or ligand binds to the receptor, one and the same. But in general, the receptors are fixed, but the ligand is flexible molecule which has to pass through the various parameters. Suppose if ligand is a drug molecule, when you take in the drug, it has to pass through several regions before it reaches its target, that is the receptor. Here the receptor is not moving, whereas the drug molecule will be moving inside the biological solutions. So always the receptor will be fixed, whereas the ligand will be moving. So here the ligand is a complementary partner molecule that binds to the receptor for effective biomolecular response. So example of a ligand is any drug or any biological molecule. Docking. Docking is a molecular modeling technique designed to find the proper fit between the ligand and its binding site. That is what we have seen. If this was the orientation of the ligand and this was the orientation of the protein, then the fit will be perfect. And whereas if you try to fit this ligand into this conformation of the ligand into the active site of the protein, then the fit will not be proper. So docking will help us find the proper fit between the ligand and the binding site of the protein. And docking pose: a ligand molecule can bind with a receptor in multiple positions, conformations and orientation. Each such docking mode is called as docking pose. What is docking pose? A ligand molecule can bind with the receptor in multiple positions or conformations and orientations. Such docking mode is called docking pose. I'll explain you with a diagram. So here if you see, this is a protein, this is a protein molecule, complete protein molecule, and inside the protein molecule there is a site called active site. In the active site you can see that there is a ligand binded to it, there is a ligand molecule occupying the active site. Now if you see, play the video, the ligand molecule is taking several conformations and several orientations. Okay, so each time when it is interacting with the protein, so that pose is called as a docking pose. So there are several number of docking poses generated inside the binding site of the protein. So as you can see, this is the active site of the protein. Inside this active site, the ligand molecule is taking several poses or several conformations or positions which are binding with the receptor. So each binding mode of the ligand with the receptor active site is called as a docking pose. Now, so that was about docking pose and docking score. The process of evaluating a particular pose by counting the number of favorable intermolecular interactions. So now you have seen several docking poses. Each time, so for each docking pose, this docking program will try to find the best favorable interactions. So you know that the favorable interactions like hydrogen bonding interactions, van der Waals interactions and hydrophobic interactions. So if there is a proper hydrogen bonding and if there is a proper hydrophobic bonding or hydrophobic interactions, then that binding pose will get best affinity between the ligand and the receptor molecule. So for every docking pose, several intermolecular interactions are observed. If they are favorable, then the binding affinity will be good, and if the interactions are not good, then the binding affinity will be less. So based on it, doc score will be generated. Based on it, for every doc pose, doc score will be generated. And after the doc score has been generated, the next one is evaluation or ranking. So ranking is the process of classifying which ligands are more likely to interact favorably to a particular receptor based on the free energy of binding. So we have seen what is a docking pose and what is a docking score. So these docking scores are based on favorable interactions, as we have said, that is hydrogen bonding interactions or hydrophobic interactions. And then after this docking scores have been generated, so these docking scores are based on the concept of free energy of binding, so the lesser the free energy of binding, the greater will be the binding affinity. So for every docking pose, there is some free energy of binding calculated. So the least free energy of binding will be the best affinity between the ligand and the receptor. So the least the energy, the best will be the affinity between the ligand and the receptor. So that conformation which has the least energy will be placed on the top of the table. So it is ranked 1. So accordingly, second rank, third rank, of different conformations for a particular ligand, or different ligands can be calculated. Next, scoring or affinity prediction. This affinity prediction or scoring functions are applied to the energetically best pores. So the affinity will be finding for the conformations which have the best pores. So that can be calculated by delta G binding is equal to delta G INT, delta G solvation, delta G conformation, delta G motion. These are nothing but delta G is the ligand receptor interactions. Okay, and then delta G is the interactions of the ligand and receptor with the solvent, that is water. And then delta G conformation is conformational changes occurring in the ligand and the receptor, and delta G motion is the motion in the movement in the protein and ligand during the complex formation. So delta G bind is equal to delta G of interactions ligand and receptor. Delta G solvent is the interactions of the solvent with the ligand as well as the receptor, and conformations are the conformations generated in the ligand and the receptor. And delta G motion is the motion, that is the movement which is occurring in the process of docking for protein as well as the ligand. And so these are some of the general terms which are encountered in the process of docking. So we have discussed about the definition of docking and the several definitions associated with the docking. And next, what are the basic steps involved in docking? So coming to the basic steps involved in docking, the first step, ligand preparation. The first step, ligand preparation. Or you can do protein preparation and then followed by ligand preparation, or it can be like ligand preparation followed by protein preparation. It doesn't matter. So the first step it involves is ligand preparation. In this process, the duplicate structures should be removed. There is no fun in docking the duplicate structures. Why? Because whatever the parameters we get for the first structure, the duplicate also gets the second structure. So instead of wasting time, remove the duplicate structures. And options for ionization change, we need to check whether they are ionizable or not. Tautomerization state should be fixed. Isomer generation should be done. Isomers, you know that if there is a possible of isomerism, then those isomers should be generated for the ligand. Isomers should be generated for the ligand, and after generation then we say that the ligand has been prepared. So we need to generate several conformations, we need to find several isomers if they are possible, and we need to generate tautomer states if they are possible. Then after pre-processing of every ligand, then we say that the ligand has been prepared, and then followed by protein preparation. In this protein preparation, what we need to do, we need to add protons to the complete protein molecule. Protein, we need to add protonated. The protein should be protonated first, and then followed by, we said that when during the process of crystal formation between the ligand and the protein, they have crystallized and their PDB is evaluated. So during the process, some water molecules get entrapped into the crystal structure of the protein and ligand. So what we need to do is the basic criteria. The water molecules which are present in the active site have to be retained, whereas the water molecules which are away from the active site have to be removed in the process of protein preparation. The water molecules which are entrapped in the active site must be restored, whereas the water molecules which are away from the active site have to be excluded in the process of protein preparation. Then we need to fix some errors like incomplete residues. If some residues like water residues, amino acids present in the active site, there may be some additions, deletions occurring. We need to check for any deletions or any incomplete residues observed in the active site. If there are some incomplete residues found in the active site, they need to be fixed in the active site. Why? Because they may cause some interactions with the ligand during the process of docking, so they must be fixed. So that is nothing but doing protein preparation. And next, after the ligand has been prepared and the protein has been prepared, we need to go for ligand protein docking. So in this ligand protein docking, what we do is we need to find the best possible orientation between the ligand and the protein so that we get the free energy of binding will be very low and the affinity between the ligand and the protein will be good. So this may be of grid based docking. Grid based docking is nothing but placing a grid in the active site of the protein. It is nothing but placing a grid in the active site of the protein, and this grid will be generated in such a way that the centroid of the ligand, you know that the ligand molecule has a different shape, and the centroid for the ligand molecule, the grid box is generated at the centroid. So grid box is generated in such a way that it will be at the centroid of the ligand molecule in the active site of the receptor, in the active site of the receptor. So this is nothing but grid based docking. And sometimes we do not go with grid generation, we directly go to find the active pocket in the protein, and then we bind the, we try to dock the ligands into the active site of the protein. So two types, one it may be like a grid based, like we need to generate a grid which will be at the centroid of the ligand, which will be at the centroid of the ligand, and the all the ligand molecules will be docked into the grid, will all the ligand molecules will be docked into the grid. This is grid based docking. And other thing is we may not use a grid, but we may dock directly into the active site of the protein. So that is about ligand protein docking, and we will be finding the what is the best possible orientation between the ligand and the protein, and categorization of docking or the types of docking. So coming to the categorization, it is of first one is the protein ligand docking. Most of the time we have been discussing about protein ligand docking. So ligand will be a very small molecule and protein will be a very large molecule. You can see here the protein is very large compared to the ligand. Ligand is very small. The ligand can fix into the active site of the protein. So target, that is protein plus ligand, in the process of molecular docking, the ligand is occupying the active site of the protein. So this is a diagrammatic representation of protein ligand docking. And coming to protein nucleic acid docking, there are also different types of docking, in which the second one is protein nucleic acid docking. As you can see, this is the nucleic acid, this is nucleic acid, double stranded DNA structure on some active site of the nucleic acid. Active site of the nucleic acid, we are trying to dock the protein. This is a protein, the green color structure is a protein which is interacting with the nucleic acid. This is called as protein nucleic acid docking. And the another case is protein protein docking. There are some cases where we need to dock a protein with the another protein. As you can see, this is a protein and this is the active site of the protein for protein protein docking. So you can see that the second protein, it is binding with the first protein. So this is the active site for protein protein docking. So this is a diagrammatic representation where one protein is being docked into the another protein. So the three types of docking is ligand protein docking, protein nucleic acid docking, and protein protein docking. Among all these types of docking, the most commonly used one in structure based drug design is protein ligand docking. Among these, protein ligand docking is a common research area because of its importance in structure based drug design. And next, coming to protein ligand docking, most of the time we discuss about protein ligand docking. Why? Because it is of more usefulness in structure based drug design. So coming to protein ligand docking, it can be classified in the following types. Like first one is rigid body docking, the second one is flexible ligand docking, and the third one is flexible docking. So what are these rigid body docking, flexible ligand docking, and flexible docking, we'll be discussing. Coming to rigid body docking, where both the receptors and the ligand are treated as rigid. So here in rigid body docking, what we do is we keep the shape of a protein as well as the ligand fixed, means they are rigid, they will not change. So and
keeping them fixed, we need to dock the ligand into the receptor binding site. So that type of docking is called rigid body docking. Next, flexible ligand docking, in which the receptor will be rigid but the ligand is treated as flexible. The ligand is treated as flexible. So that is flexible ligand docking. And what is flexible docking? Where both the receptor and ligand flexibility is considered. We need to make the receptor or the protein flexible as well as the ligand molecule flexible. Both are flexible. And then followed by docking. So that is nothing but flexible docking.
Next is the docking program and docking algorithm. We know that the docking program needs some docking algorithm to proceed with the docking. So what is this docking algorithm and what it is useful for? So the docking program depends on docking algorithm. The docking program will be depending on docking algorithm. And what is docking algorithm? These are the methods. Docking algorithms are the methods used to predict the possible conformations of binary complex. And docking algorithms are the methods which are used to predict the possible conformations of binary complex. What is a binary complex? A ligand and a protein, or it may be a protein and a protein. So the most common form of docking program is ligand and protein. So here the binary complex may be considered as a ligand and a protein complex. So what is the best possible conformation of this binary complex will be predicted by docking algorithms. So the main objective of docking algorithm is to obtain a fast method which is able to discover novel lead compounds. So based on this binary complex formation, the finding of free energy of binding, so that will help in the design of, or that will help in the discovery of novel lead molecule. So this docking is also called as virtual screening, as we have discussed earlier. And the most commonly used docking algorithm use rigid receptor and flexible ligand model. The most commonly used docking algorithm uses a rigid receptor. When we have said that the protein will be rigid whereas the ligand will be flexible. So apart from it, what is the other type of docking algorithm? So you can see the receptor ligand docking can be based on receptor flexibility. It may be depending on ligand sampling and flexibility and scoring function. So what are these receptor flexibility, ligand sampling and flexibility and scoring functions, we will be discussing in brief. So sometimes apart from rigid receptor, we need to induce some flexibility in the receptor. Apart from rigid receptor, sometimes in docking purposes, we need to induce some flexibility in the receptor to get the best docking results. So here the receptor flexibility is nothing but the ligand binding usually induces protein conformational changes from local layer rearrangement to large domain motions or induced fit. What is induced fit? This is nothing but when a ligand is interacting with the protein adjusts its shape of the active site so that it can accommodate the incoming ligand to bind with it. So that is nothing but induced fit model. Upon ligand binding, in order to maximize energetically favorable interaction. So why is the protein taking some shapes? So it is giving some conformations for the active site because the ligand can interact favorably and maximize the interactions and reduce the binding energy. So the protein flexibility can be grouped into four major categories. That is receptor flexibility or protein flexibility. It is of four types. One is soft docking, side chain flexibility, molecular relaxation and protein ensemble docking. So coming to the first type, soft docking. So soft docking algorithms attempt to allow flexibility in the receptor and ligand structures by using a relaxed representation of molecular surface. So here both the receptor will be made flexible and the ligand will be made flexible and they are allowed to proceed with docking. So that is soft docking methodology. The next is side chain flexibility. So here it allows the active side chains. Active side, side chain flexibility is another type of provide receptor flexibility. Why? Because the docking will be done in the active side. So the side chains which are present in the active side, they must be made flexible to accommodate the interactions with the ligand. So the side chain flexibility can be induced. The optimized ligand side chain orientations are then scored in order to rank the lowest energy combination. We need to find the lowest energy combination, then only the binding affinity will be good. So this is nothing but inducing side chain flexibility in the active site. This is complete protein flexibility, this is side chain flexibility. And coming to molecular relaxation, the molecular relaxation method accounts for protein flexibility by first using rigid body docking to place the ligand in the bonding site and then relaxing the protein backbone and side chain atoms nearby. So here in molecular relaxation, what we will be doing is, first we will be taking the protein which is a rigid conformation. So in that rigid conformation we have an active site, in that the ligand will be placed. And after that, the protein will be relaxed by relaxing the protein backbone. What is protein backbone? You know that an amino acid interacts with the another amino acid and it interacts with the another amino acid. So what is the bond formed between the amino acids? Amide bond, that is NHCO bonds. And the next time also NSCH bond, NSCO bond. So we have n number of NSCO bonds. So that is nothing but protein backbone. So that protein backbone will be made relaxed and side chain atoms will also be made relaxed in the active site. So this is nothing but first placing the ligand in the active site and then relaxing the protein. So that is about molecular relaxation. And next is docking of multiple protein structures. Docking of multiple protein structures. What we'll do is we try to generate several conformations for different proteins. Several conformations of the protein, and suppose we get around four different conformations for a particular protein, we try to dock the ligand into the four different conformations. So that is nothing but ensemble docking or docking of multiple protein structures. And this ensemble of different conformations of the protein can be obtained from NMR solutions or multiple X-ray crystal structures. Multiple X-ray crystal structures. So they are made use of to get the information about the protein conformation. So different conformations will be docked individually with different ligands. So this is about docking of multiple protein structures or ensemble docking. And next, coming to ligand sampling and flexibility. Coming to ligand sampling and flexibility, ligand sampling is one of the most basic components in protein ligand docking. Given a protein target, the sampling algorithm generates possible ligand orientations and conformations around the binding site. We know that the ligand should be made to generate several conformations or poses in the active binding site. So that is all about ligand sampling and flexibility, and how it is done, and how is this ligand sampling or flexibility done. It is based on shape matching and systematic search. The shape matching approach is one of the common sampling approach that is employed in the initial stages of docking. So here, what should be done is, the ligand is placed using the criterion that molecular surface of the placed ligand must harmonize the molecular surface of the binding site. So whatever the shape of the active site, so that active site shape should be complementary to the shape of the designed ligand. Then only the ligand can go and bind into the active site. If they are not complementary, the ligand cannot go and bind into the active site of the protein. So that is about shape matching. So desirable shape complementarity is very must when before docking, so that the ligand can go and bind into the active site of the protein.
And next, systematic searching. Systematic search algorithms are usually employed for flexible ligand docking, which creates all probable ligand binding conformations. So we know that we have seen in the starting of this class, like there are several poses of a ligand for binding in the active site of the protein. So we need to find all the binding conformations of that ligand. We need to bind all the binding conformations, the minimum energy binding conformations of the ligand. And this systematic search can be divided into three subclasses. What are they? First one is exhaustive search, next one is fragmentation approach, and the next one is conformational ensemble. In exhaustive search, what we do is we try to generate the maximum possible number of conformations. And how this is done? By rotating all the possible bonds. By rotating all the possible bonds which can be rotated, they are made to rotate and find each possible and find n number of conformations. So these all conformations will be docked into the active site of the protein. So that is done in exhaustive search. So we are trying to find the best conformation out of several number of conformations. We try to find the best conformation out of several number of conformations generated. So that is done in exhaustive search. In fragment approach, what we do is we divide the ligand into a number of fragments. We divide the ligand into a number of fragments, and then ligand binding conformation is grown by placing one fragment at a time. So it is something like growing the ligand. First we break the ligand into pieces or fragments, and each fragment will be placed in the binding site, and then we find the suitable interactions, and accordingly we grow the ligand, so that ultimately we get a conformation of the ligand which will be the best conformation for binding. So that is about fragment approach. And next is conformation ensemble. So here what we do is we generate all the different possible conformation at once, and then we try to generate all the different possible conformations, and then the pre-generated ligand conformations will be docked into the active site of the protein. Here you can see in the conformational ensemble methods, the ligand flexibility is achieved by rigidly docking an ensemble of pre-generated ligand conformations with other programs like Omega. So here we need to generate all the possible conformations of the ligand, and then we need to dock into the protein active site. So the ligand flexibility is achieved by rigidly docking an ensemble of pre-generated ligand conformations. Okay, so during the process of docking, we are not generating conformations, but the already generated conformations will be docked into the protein surface. So protein active site. So this is about conformation ensemble, the combination, the total sum of conformations. So this is exhaustive search, this is about fragmentation approach, and next is conformation ensemble. And next two, we'll be discussing about the scoring functions. And what are the scoring functions? So scoring functions are the mathematical functions used to approximately predict the binding affinity between two molecules, that is ligand and protein. You know that the ligand will bind to the protein, and when it binds, there are some calculations done, like to predict the binding affinity, like free energy calculations. So the scoring functions are nothing but they are the mathematical functions used to predict the binding affinity between the two molecules, that is ligand and protein. So, and what are the different types of scoring functions used? They are like force field scoring functions, empirical scoring functions, knowledge based scoring functions, and consensus scoring. And what are they, we'll be discussing. This force field scoring functions rely on partitioning of ligand binding energy into individual interaction terms like van der Waals energies, electrostatic energies, bending, torsion energies, employing force field parameters
and the software uses like Amber and Charm. These are developed, these are based on force field functions. The Amber and Charm, these are based on force field functions. So here what we do is we will be measuring individual ligand binding energies. What are they, like van der Waal energies, electrostatic energies, they will be find out to find the binding affinity between the ligand and the protein. As you can see in the diagram, this is Lennard Jones potential, that is interatomic distance. This is torsional angle, that is rotational angle. You can see the arrow, this is the rotational angle, and here this is the bond length, or this is the measurement of angle between the three bonds, the measurement of angle between the three bonds, and bond length is also a criteria. So here in force field we'll be measuring individual terms, and we'll be trying to predict the binding affinity between the ligand and the protein. This is about force field, which is dependent on Charm and Amber. What is Charm and Amber? There is some abbreviation. Amber is assisted model building with energy refinement, and Charm is chemistry at Harvard Macromolecular Mechanics. And next is empirical scoring function. What is this empirical scoring function? So here in the force field functions we were calculating individual parameters, van der Waals, electrostatic, etc. But here we'll be calculating, it is dependent on weighted adding up of weighted empirical energy terms like van der Waal energy, electrostatic energy. There we were finding individually. Here we add up the individual terms and we try to find the overall binding affinity between the ligand and the protein. So here the binding energy score of a complex is calculated by adding up set of weighted empirical energy terms such as van der Waals energy, electrostatic energy, hydrogen bonding energy in empirical scoring functions. And these functions are very simple compared to force field functions. What is knowledge based scoring functions? The knowledge based scoring functions will result from the structural information, of an experimentally determined protein ligand complex. So this knowledge based is dependent on experimentally determined protein ligand complexes in from the literature. So that will be dependent on potential mean force, or which is an inverse of Boltzmann constant. It is dependent on Boltzmann constant. So that is about knowledge based scoring function. And what is consensus scoring? So you know that the scoring functions are categorized into force field functions, empirical scoring functions, and knowledge based scoring functions. So each one of them have some merits as well as some demerits. So a combination of force field, empirical, and knowledge based scoring functions gives us consensus scoring function. So it is nothing but it is a combination of knowledge based, empirical, as well as force field functions. So it will be more robust in estimating the binding affinity between the protein and the ligand. So consensus scoring is not a typical scoring function, rather it is a technique involved in protein ligand docking. It advances the probability of finding an accurate solution by amalgamating the scoring information from multiple scoring functions, that is empirical, knowledge, and force field, in the anticipation of eliminating inaccuracies of individual scoring functions. We know that there are some limitations with individual scoring functions, so they can be eliminated if we go for consensus scoring function. So this is all about docking and what are the applications of docking. The major specific applications of docking are the determination of low free energy structures for receptor ligand complexes. We need to find the low free energy structures. So what is the best possible conformation for a ligand to react with the interact with the protein, we will be finding out. And calculation of different differential binding of a ligand to different macromolecules. So we have the same ligand which can combine with different proteins, so we can also find the differential binding energy. Differential binding, what is the energy for first protein and what is the energy for the secondary protein, second protein. And study of geometry of particular ligand receptor complex, we can study the geometry of ligand receptor complex. And we can search a database for ranking of hits. We know that hits are the top ranked molecules in the docking program. So we can create, we can search a database and we can rank the hits or lead generations, and we can also optimize the ligand to become a drug molecule. We can also optimize the ligand to become a drug molecule. And we can also modify the lead molecules to improve potency and other properties. And we can also go for library design and data bank generation using this docking approach. And next one is, we can screen for some side effects like interactions with proteases and cytochrome P450, and it is also useful in predicting protein-protein interactions. In some cases where protein-protein interactions are to be studied, we can go for docking programs. And also it is useful for finding the potential pharmacological targets. What are the potential pharmacological targets we can reveal? And docking based virtual HTS, this is high throughput screening, is less expensive than normal HTS. So docking based one will take less time and more economical compared to the high throughput screening which we do in the laboratory wet lab. So it may take some time, but a docking program will take less time. So it has some advantages over normal high throughput screening. So this is all about the docking.